Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. This video is about Animoto. Animoto is a video tool. It allows you very quickly to produce videos, and those videos can include music and writing and images. Now, it's a free tool. We're going to concentrate on using Animoto as a free tool, and we're focusing on using Animoto in language teaching, though in all honesty, you could use it in any area of the curriculum. One of the things I like about Animoto, apart from the fact it's so easy to make a video, and it's great, of course, to get students to make videos because it's a free tool, but when you make a video, you can save it on your computer, you can download it, you can embed it, and you can share the link. So it's really easy to distribute the videos once you've made them. Great tool for teachers to show to students. You could use it for lots of different things as well. Really hope you like this video. And as always, if you do, please like it. Please share it with other teachers. Please comment on it. And let's get started.
So here we are on the opening page of Animoto. You will obviously need to sign up. I've actually got an account, so I'm just going to log in and I'll see you on the other side. So let's start by immediately creating a video. So we're logged in. To create, we just click on this button here. And you've got basically a choice. You can start from scratch and you can click on this button here, and that's fine, it will work fine, and we'll perhaps come back and have a quick look at that. Or what you can do is just choose one of these templates, which will kind of make it easier for you to get started. So we'll choose holidays and we'll use this one. We get a whole series of different templates that we can choose. We're just going to take one of these. You can change everything in the template anyway, so it really doesn't matter. And let's say, for example, that we're going to do this one here, my New Year's story. Okay, so what's been my story so far this year? We click on it and we get a sample of what it's going to look like. Okay, and let's just stop that a minute and imagine that we want to use this one. We're going to click on Choose Template, and that's going to open up the template with some pictures in there and some text, etc. And our job will be now to kind of switch the pictures and the text so that it suits us. Now, you can load up pictures at this stage, okay? So if you wanted to suddenly bring in some pictures, I generally don't do that. I just skip that stage, get to here. Because I can always just click on project and bring in my own pictures from here. Okay, so now we can see the animation that we've chosen or the template that we've chosen. And now what we've got to do is edit it. But I'm going to give you a couple of tips before we start doing that. So the first thing I suggest that you do is just get familiar with actually playing it so you can see what is currently available. And to do that, just click here. And that will actually play the video for you. It kind of renders the video and actually plays it for you so you can see what the video is going to look like. So it's kind of a good idea to quickly do that. Video is going to start. Now we won't play anymore. Click on close preview. Let's imagine that you wanted to start to edit this. Well, my first recommendation with you to you would be click on ratio and change it to landscape. It's just way easier and it looks much better when you change most of the videos to landscape, and it's so much easier to edit it. Now we can jump to any of the different pictures, okay, and edit them. So let's start with that first one. It's already on the screen. I can literally just click on here. Okay, and obviously click from here and just edit this completely. So I'm deleting the text, and then I'm going to write my own text in, and I'm going to say, this has been a tough year. Sorry, put it better. Yeah, year so far. Okay, and I've now edited the first slide. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the second slide and I can immediately edit this as well. But you might say to yourself, well, I don't want this picture. So what you're then going to need to do is to get some pictures. Now, if you click on stock pictures, you'll see that actually the majority of the pictures on stock, not all of them, are paid for. There are some that are free. So let me just do an example. Let's imagine that we want to use this image here. This doesn't say that I need to pay for it. So I'm going to drag that and put it onto the screen, and you'll see that it updates. Now, a lot of stock pictures, if you search for stock pictures, and let me just give you an example. If I click on books and click on enter, you'll probably notice that quite a lot of the stock pictures you need to go pro. But there will be always some pictures that you can make use of in the stock, generally, that you can make use of that are actually available to free to you. The other thing you can do in terms of pictures is click on project and just import any pictures that you want. Just click here. It's going to open up your computer. I've got some pictures here that I can work with. I'm just going to grab some of these and use them. So we'll just do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm going to click on open. And now I've imported those pictures in. Now I'm going to show you another little trick that you can do to kind of speed up the process when you're editing your videos. So remember, project is where you bring your pictures in, and stock is where you get access to the pictures that are available to you from Animoto. And most of them you do need to pay for, but some of them are free. Okay, we click on photos here, you'll see that there's a fair number of photos that are free. So if we jumped onto this third one, okay, and let's say I'm going to click here and say change this one to I did a lot of sport this year. All right, okay. So in fact, I should really say I have done a lot of sport, because we're still making it through the middle. So I have done a lot of sport this year, and I'm going to just change that picture. So I'm going to drag that one and just drop that on. Okay, don't drag it here because that's the text. Drag it under here, and that will replace that picture. Okay, so, and let's just jump onto the next one now. And instead of using a picture from the stock, I'm going to use one of the pictures that I have from my own computer. So I'm going to then drag that on, and that's going to replace that. And I'm going to write in this one here, I made some new friends. Okay, so I'm building up this text. Now there's another little trick here that we can use. Okay, you've got up to a maximum of 15 pictures. If I want to, I can kind of drag another picture on. And what you can do, instead of actually clicking on an image and then just replacing it by dragging a picture over, if we come back to the stock again and perhaps just drag this picture onto the screen, okay, so that's one way. Then we can change the text here. But another thing we can actually do is actually just simply drag the text. Let me just find a nice one to use. Drag the text onto the screen. We'll put that one there, okay. And that, if I just drag it there, that will kind of add to the number of different images that you've got on the screen. If you drag an image on like that on its own, so let's just do it one more. So let's, I'm going to drag this one onto the screen. Notice that you will have to then add the text yourself. So if we, obviously we've got that one selected at the moment. To add the text, you would just click here and then you can add your text. Now you don't have to put a title and a subtitle. You can just click on that and delete the subtitle and then just put your title in and write, for example, I visited some lovely places in the UK because I could not travel. Okay, so you can kind of build this up by clicking through and changing the text. Okay, you're not limited, by the way, when you want to you can obviously add pictures and add text, etc., onto the screen. You can as well change a little bit the design. So even though you've chosen a particular template which kind of controls a lot of things, if you click on here, okay, if you click on design, you can actually kind of change that, and that will change the text. So for example, let's click on this one here, okay, and then that's going to refresh, and that will actually change the way the text looks now on the screen. So you've even got the option not only to choose a certain template, but even within a template you can then click on the design button. So that's the design button and the ratio button. That's obviously a useful button to undo. We can also change the music. So if we click here, if we want to change the music, we've got some music obviously on here, we can just delete that music And then you can, for example, let's choose fun. And it brings up a whole range of songs. You can roll over and listen to them. And I'm going to choose this one here. So I'm going to click on plus. And that will add that song. Just know to be careful when you roll over. It starts to play the songs almost immediately. Okay, so just keep that in mind. And again, nice interface this. You close the button. So we've now done quite a lot to this. We've added new pictures, etc. And we might want to just go through and make sure that we're happy with everything. One thing to keep in mind when you're making a kind of presentation is, and we'll do this with the stock. If we click here, notice that some of the stock are actually pictures. Some of the stock are actually videos. So it's not always that when you drag a stock image into your production that it's actually just going to be a stationary video, a stationary image. You may have an actual animation. And I'll just give you an example. So if I drop this one in here so that we've added that into our collection, just okay, you'll see now that that particular one, and if we just click on that, we can actually play it by just clicking here, and you can actually play it also by clicking on it. If I just pause it a minute, you can also just click on it and that will play it as well. So you're not always working with images. You sometimes are working with video. If we click here, we can choose the layout for a particular image or a particular slide. So if I click here, I do get lots of ways of making that, including, for example, here, if I want to have, say, a white space where I could add some text on this side, okay, or, you know, choose another one. So you've also got that option here, okay. I'm going to delete that top part or bottom part, and then I'm just going to write, I had my birthday. Okay, I'm just going to leave it like that. So you get the idea. Now, once we're done and we're happy with our recording, the next thing that we need to do is, and one final tip, sorry that I didn't say, make sure you give it a name. So I'm going to click here and just call this one My Year to Date. Okay, the most important thing you need to do is, once you've done it, you can, if you want to, just play it and just check that you're happy. Okay, you can do that. But if you want to, you can also export. So now it's time to export. This is where Animoto is really good, even in the free account. If you click on the export button, it's going to render your video first of all. And once it's done that, okay, so my video is rendered. I can actually play the video now, okay? But now that it's rendered, I've got all of these options. I'm going to just take you through some of these. One of the most obvious ones is to click on Copy Link. And that produces a link that then you can share. So a student can share their link with their teacher, or they could perhaps share their link onto Edmodo so that other students could watch it. Okay, so you've got loads of options here in terms of, first thing that we can do is we can copy the link as a student and share our video with the rest of our class. So that's one option. Now you also have the option to download that video. So if you click download, and you'll notice, though you can't download it at the highest quality without paying, you can download it at standard quality or even at medium quality, okay, or low quality. So for example, if I click here, notice that I can actually download that video onto my own computer. Because I'm using Google Chrome, that will appear in my downloads, and then I can share that video. So if I was to click and open my folder now, showing folder, you can see that that video has been downloaded onto my computer. So that's another option. This is one of the really good things about Animoto, is that you have got loads of options once you've made a video to how you can use it. Just a really quick break from the video. If you like what you're seeing and you want more free videos, please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Loads of different technologies across the top here, but these special sections are what are becoming very popular, and I'm planning on adding some new ones. If you want to learn about digital skills, you want lesson ideas, there's going to be interviews on teachers, there's going to be all the free tools in the special section. If you want to follow my work, then the best thing to do is to sign up to my newsletter, and that way you'll get updated with all of the blogs and the online courses that I run and the webinars that I do and any new videos that come along. And at the moment, if you sign up to the newsletter, there's a kind of special 10-part course that you're also given on integrating technology into your teaching and learning. Right, let's get back to the video. Now, you also have the option as well to embed the video. So that's another option. As you can see, actually, you've got loads of options here, but let's just go through these ones, okay? So if you click on embed, you'll notice that it produces a code. If it doesn't produce that code, because sometimes it doesn't, just kind of click on one of these buttons and then often the code is produced. But I'm going to actually show you how this works. So I'll choose a slightly bigger size. So I'm going to choose that size. Okay, it produces the code. And I'm going to choose loop, which means that the video will keep playing. Now I'm going to press on copy. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to embed this into a blog just to show you how easy it is to do that. Now, most systems that accept an embed code, things like Edmodo, things like Moodle, things like Blackboard, I'm using Blogger here, WordPress, just click on wherever you want to add your code in. And in my case, when I'm working with Blogger, all I need to do in Blogger is simply make sure that I'm in the correct mode for adding the content in. And to do that, all I need to do is to click on the button over here and change it to HTML mode, because I can't paste the code in directly onto the screen. So just click on HTML mode, and it's so easy. I just simply paste in that code, nothing else to do at all. And now that will actually be ready. And if I clicked on preview just to quickly show you, you'll see now that that video is actually embedded in to the screen. There it is. Okay, so really easy once you copy a code, then paste it into whatever device you want to work with. And basically what that embedded code is doing is playing the video from the Animoto site. Remember, you're not downloading the video into Blogger, you're simply linking to the video that's on Animoto and you're playing it through Blogger. So keep that in mind, you're not actually taking a physical copy of the video. Anytime you want to get back to the main page, just come up to the screen here and click on that little kind of icon. That always brings you back to the main page. It's a pretty good interface. That's your create button. And if you come here, you've got your details about your account here. In my case at the moment, I'm just using a free account, and you can access your videos here. Really hope that video was useful to you. Please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Lots of different technologies across the top here, including a whole section on different Google tools. But if you want to learn more about digital skills, the types of things that I've just showed you in the last video, then click here. There's a great selection of videos that will help you with different digital skills. If you want to follow my work, the best thing to do is to sign up to the newsletter. That way you get updated with all the blogs, the webinars, the online courses, and of course the new videos. You can also subscribe to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to click on the bell so that you get updated when new videos come out. And finally, if you do want to contact me about me doing some training with your organization, you can contact me from the website. And thank you very much.
Here on the screen, there's a few more videos that you might be interested in looking at. These are all free videos from me helping you to use technology. So just click on them to watch another video.